guys, it's your girl Dion, and we're back with tier 2 of building in the Sims 4 Tiny Living stuff pack that was released just on the 21st, so not too long from now, a couple days ago. So this was the second house that I ended up building, and I did kind of go smallest to biggest, even though that's the biggest house, so the tier 3 was somehow became the more challenging one for me, probably because it was for 8 Sims with 99 square tiles. So yeah, not that easy. So this one here is a max of 64 square tiles, so still not too shabby. I was able to fit in an entire bedroom, bathroom, kitchen, living area, dining room, etc. Kind of like some extra activity things. I really wanted to push myself and like try and get some extra activities like I usually do in all of my houses, while keeping it not too cluttered and obviously so usable. It's also, oh, hold up. Okay, so my cat just escaped from my room. But it is also has, items in there for, pets. So, and washer and dryer as well. So, it's quite multifunctional, I like to say. Now there is not a dog bed because I did it more for a dog than a cat. So the dog is either sleeping on the bed with you or it's sleeping on a couch, but, yeah, I didn't think you want the pet to sleep outside or the dog to sleep outside. I mean, he could technically, but I mean, like, if you think about it, we're kind of building the desert, and there are coyotes, and, yeah, that wouldn't be a good thing if it was kind of mano a mano on that one. But for the Sala house, it was definitely, I don't want to say a struggle to get out of the same color pattern as the first house that I did in this, I guess we can call series, just because the items that we did get in the stuff pack was kind of limited to the color range. So, I mean, I wish we had the color wheel that we had back in The Sims 3, so we could actually customize every single item that you wanted to and that you weren't so stuck with the same color palette in an idea sense, if that makes sense. I don't know. I just wish that we had the color wheel so we can make things, you know, ours, our own, basically, in a sense. I just miss it. It would have been nice. It would have been very helpful, especially for this pack. Like, I love the style of it. I do not get me wrong. It very much does fit the style of the bowling stuff pack, to which it had some good things on there, but, like, that was just wasn't enough. And it was, like, the most random style that did not fit with anything else in the game. Anyways, that's beyond here or there. But, yeah, I just wish that we had the color wheel back. Also, one thing that I kind of noticed in the first video that I uploaded, and I did not mention it, but the couch that comes with this Murphy bed does not match anything else in the game. Like, there is no side tables that match it. There is no, living room chairs. No, there's nothing. Like, maybe these dining room chairs match, but, like, I'm not gonna use that in my living room. Like, the only reason it's even this close to the living room is the fact that it is this small of a house. Yeah, it does not make sense to me. I don't get it. I really don't. And I'll be honest, I didn't honestly even know what color palette I was going for in this house until I did the living room. So, we kind of went with oranges and we kind of went with yellows, but you know what? It works in the end. But back to that Murphy bed. It drives me crazy how there is nothing that matches that couch. Just saying. Like, come on. Give us some variations of options here. Also, one thing that I kind of do wish that we were able to do is, like, how you can snap on the bookshelves to the side of the Murphy bed. I wish you could choose different love seats to put onto it. I think that would have been pretty awesome. Also, that way you can honestly customize it to any and every sofa that we have in the game. And, I mean, if they're able to make decor into bookshelf, I mean, here's the thing. If they're able to make the bookshelf decors into actual bookshelves, then should they not be able to make the couches all, like, collapsible, if that makes sense? I don't know. I think they should have made it so you're able to snap on love seats onto the Murphy bed so you can have somewhat of variety, because it's great and all if you have the Murphy bed, but if you have it in a lot of your households, they're gonna have the exact same couch. And then it's the exact same style because you have to match it. So, I don't know. I just wish that you were able to interchange that. Also, I kind of wish that you were able to change the picture that comes on the Murphy bed as well. Yes, I know this is a lot of me saying I wish, I wish, I wish. I just, I love the idea of the whole compact living idea, but I also wish it was just a little bit more versatile for changing the styles in the house because let's just say that your Sim is very, Victorian era, old school decor, but they live in a tiny apartment, they're gonna use a Murphy bed, and it's like a modern mod, not eco, but that style of couch. Like, it just doesn't really make the most sense. So yeah, I just wish we were able to change it up. Also, I don't even know why I didn't think of it or realize it until this room, but a lot of the wall lamps are like oversized. Like, I don't know, I just feel like they're super large. I don't know. It was just a very weird observation that I had, so I'm just saying it. But this room is definitely like giving me like a, I don't know, 90s feel, but just very like Mod Podge 80s color vibe. I don't know. I like it. It's very different from the rest of the house because lots of bold colors, not a lot of patterns, just bold colors. And yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I kind of like it. I think it works for like this weird modern house, but I thought it worked. And then yeah, just adding in a few small extra touches here and there and kind of make it feel not so blah on the walls. That's one thing I do notice I always have issues with is I leave a lot of blank space because I use more items than wall objects because I always forget about the wall objects, to be honest. I never think about, oh, let's get a wall object in. Like, that's just not what I'd be thinking. And then just kind of adding a little bit of greenery out here, just in the fact if you're gonna be living in a really small house, you probably want to have some outdoor living space. So all three of the houses in this three-part mini series build do have the outdoor living space. And I'm also, I don't know, I'm recording these weird. I'm recording it. Oh no, I'm not. Why am I saying that? Who knows? For some reason, I was thinking in my mind that I was recording things backwards, but I'm like, no, you built it backwards. You're recording it right. Who knows? My brain's lost. It's late at the time that I'm recording this, and definitely past my bedtime. Let's just say that. And then for this build, we did get planters in. I think it's the only build with planters, to be honest. Even though I think it's the tier one, you actually get the benefits. But that's all right. So this is the outside of the house. I love the roof shape. Like, it's just so cool. I love the skylight in there as well. And then we have the living room area, dining, TV, guest room, little kitchen area, just the one extra shelf that came with living. Tiny living, love it. Little laundry area. I don't know if the garbage chute would work, but I just threw it in there. And then just carrying that gold thing kind of throughout the house in the bathroom and then the master bedroom. Anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll make sure I talk to y'all later.